This is the third video in my series on concrete design and detailing with BIM. In this video, I'll cover the key Revit features for reinforced concrete. Check out all the videos in this series. Parametric modeling refers to the relationships among all elements in a project that enable the coordination and change management that Revit provides. These relationships are created automatically by the software and by you as you work. This capability delivers the fundamental coordination and productivity benefits of Revit. Change anything, anytime, anywhere in the project, and Revit propagates that change throughout the project. This is the beauty of Revit. This is how Revit is really powerful. For example, stirrups dimensions depend on the concrete element section size. If the section size is changed, the stirrups will be updated automatically following the element's dimensions, as well as shop drawings and rebar bending schedules will be updated if they already exist. Revit uses parametric modeling via families. Everything in Revit, from title blocks to 3D views to building components, such as walls or floors, beams, columns, and rebars, is part of a family. Revit families inserted into a model can have parameters that enable them to vary in height, length, depth, etc. You can have a number of different parameters for your objects. When making a change to an object within a Revit family, the parameters of other relevant objects within the family are subsequently adjusted, saving you a lot of time on your project. There is a wide range of reinforcement tools in Revit suitable for modeling reinforcement in various situations and for different types of concrete elements. These elements can range from simple columns, beams, walls, and floors to very complex double curved decks. Here is a breakdown by category and the different types of families that define each element. We can further rebar into shape-driven rebar, which gets its geometry from rebar shape family, and freeform rebar, which can have any geometry and doesn't require a rebar shape family. I will be talking about freeform rebars a bit later. There are many methods of adding rebars into concrete elements, and the choice of method depends on the individual user preferences or design context. For example, you can simply sketch the rebar shape. Using this approach, Revit automatically recognizes the shape code and assigns it to the newly created rebar instance. Another way is to use the library of shapes loaded into the project. You simply pick the desired shape from the library you want to use, set the placement plane, placement orientation, and rebar properties, click within the host sections, and Revit places rebar and expands the rebar shape to fill the space provided within a concrete element host by default. You can also quickly rotate the rebar simply by pressing the space bar if needed. In Revit 2022, we introduced also a new method for placing rebars. Revit users now are able to place rebars of exact dimensions aligned to any reference in the project with just two clicks. This reduces the number of steps needed to create bars within the desired geometry and in the exact place. This feature is huge for rebar modeling, and it is a real game changer for rebar detailers who work in Revit, my favorite feature of Revit 2022. This new method of placing rebars improves the software ease of use and users' productivity. When adding rebars of various shapes to concrete elements, you can define not only rebar diameter, but also a type of layout of a rebar set. Using rebar sets speeds up the process of adding rebar by providing a quantity of identical bars. Having rebar sets properly defined can help your rebar properly react to concrete geometry design changes. You can define accurate reinforcement for non-standard concrete element shapes by fitting rebar for non-standard geometry with rebar sets that vary along inclined faces. Moreover, you can use multi-rebar annotations, customizable numbering settings, and accurate schedules that display varying lengths. The display of varying sets in schedules can be customized by reinforcement settings. I will be talking about Rebar annotations a bit later during today's presentation. Also, Revit 2022 improves Rebar modeling and detailing for structural detailers and engineers, making it easier for you to move from disconnected CAD workflows you may still be using to BIM and enabling you to model and detail faster and more accurately. You can now move or remove individual bars in rebar sets or area and pad reinforcement systems to avoid clashes with other rebars, openings, or other elements while maintaining the logic of the rebar set or system. There is no need to split a set into multiple sets or to remove pad and area reinforcement systems, workflows that were complex and time-consuming in the past. Multiple sets or systems can be edited at the same time as well. A few seconds ago, I mentioned area and pad reinforcement systems. These are dedicated tools for the creation of planar concrete elements. We can use area reinforcement to create large amount of reinforcement in up to 4 layers in walls and floors. This tool uses a sketch to define the contour in which the bars are created and has options like spacing, bar type, hooks. The pad reinforcement tool can be used to create shape-driven reinforcement distributed along a pad in walls and floors. We also have fabric area reinforcement available in Revit. Let's have a look at one of the advantages of using area reinforcement systems. Let's imagine a situation where the wall reinforcement is already created and the detailing process, including shop drawings, has been completed. The structural designer is informed by the architect that the window opening must be enlarged or slightly moved. This is a situation where a CAD workflow would require us to perform many tedious and time-consuming manual adjustments. But let's see what happens to our reinforcement in Revit when we change the size or location of the window opening, because when we have used area reinforcement systems, our reinforcement follows the changes associated with the opening. Rebars are updated automatically and shop drawings stay up to date. Here I have used rebar constraints to have my rebars following design changes accordingly. I will be talking more on rebar constraints in a few minutes. In addition to shape-driven intelligent rebars, Revit offers you freeform rebars. You can use the freeform rebar tool to model a rebar in any concrete host, regardless of its complexity. Mostly, it's relevant mostly for civil structures, but also for regular building elements where you need a set of bars following a curve or something similar. This type of reinforcement differs from shape-driven rebar by the fact that the bars get the geometry exclusively from the geometry of the host. We call this type of reinforcement host-driven. Surface distribution of freeform rebars populates the surface of irregular shaped host with variable non-planar distribution. The bars are created by interpolating between the first and last bar of a surface distribution set. Like shape-driven rebar, freeform rebar falls under the structural rebar category and contains the typical properties for this category. You can set the layout options for the set and rebar type, defining the diameter and bending ratio, add hooks and extract fabrication data. Numbering is performed automatically. Freeform rebars can also be used to create rebar sets with planar bar distributed along the faces of a structural element and aligned to a distribution path. Just like with the surface distribution type, modeling of the aligned distribution type can be done by working in 3D views and selecting the structural element faces to which the bars are aligned. Bars in aligned distribution are created at the intersection of each individual bar plane with the host surface. all the bars, a planar, respect the cover of the host, and are aligned to the distribution path. Freeform rebars increases 3D rebar modeling versatility in Revit and helps you define the accurate reinforcement for standard and non-standard shapes of concrete elements. For the concrete elements to work as expected, corrosion resistance, etc., it is very important for bars to respect the concrete cover. In Revit, every concrete element has concrete cover settings defined. These settings can be managed and overridden. You can change rebar covers for the whole element at once or for individual faces of the concrete element. It's up to you how you manage this. When placing rebar, either directly from the library or by sketching, the bars will automatically snap to the concrete cover or nearby bars. This behavior also applies when adjusting the bars by dragging individual bar handles. To better manage accurate rebar placement, distances from a concrete cover, from a face or between rebars, we have rebar constraints in Revit defined. Rebar constraints are part of an internal mechanism used to set and lock the geometry of each rebar instance with respect to its concrete host element or other rebars. Since each rebar element can be flexed or arbitrary dimensions, Revit attempts to automatically set the position and geometry of each rebar in a manner that is meaningful to the structural designer by considering the geometry of its host, as well as the presence of other rebar. Once the rebar geometry is set, Revit automatically assigns constraints to the rebar so that it moves and flexes appropriately in response to changes that occur in the model. Using in-canvas tools, you can place rebar more precisely with the graphical rebar constraints manager. The user interface highlights each rebar segment that can be constrained along with available targets. That makes working with rebar constraints easy and intuitive. The snap constraint maintains its relationship when you place, move, drag, or copy rebar. Now, let's imagine a situation where you need to slightly adjust your concrete cover or the element section dimension must be updated. With the properly defined rebar constraints, this update would take you only a second. Now, let me talk a bit about the reinforcement connector in Revit. Rebar couplers, this is the terminology we used in Revit, are family-based and fully customizable, and each team member can use them according to their needs. Rebar couplers interact with the rebar that they connect to, facilitating change management. Structural engineers can use schematic connectors to define requirements. Detailers can use them to produce shop drawings. Manufacturers can go into a full detail, precise modeling and representing reinforcement connectors to create installation instructions. You can add the connectors to groups, assemblies, partitions with unique coupler numbering, and you can export them to various formats. Revit has also rebar numbering that enables identical reinforcement elements to be matched for schedules and tags. So if you add a rebar to your project, it will inherit a rebar number from the existing identical instance, having the same shape and dimensions. Partitioning for reinforcement identification serves several organization purposes, depending on how a building is designed or how it will be constructed. Design, ordering, fabrication, and ultimately the placement location of rebar on site all have an impact on the partitioning needs of the contractor. Any rebar set or fabric sheet instance in a model can only be assigned to one partition. Structural engineers and detailers can create design reports in Revit. They can create drawings and schedules from the 3D model more easily and quickly than from 2D designs, increasing design efficiency. The rebar quantities produced from the 3D model are more reliable than takeouts from 2D drawings, leading to accurate cost projections. Quantities are also fully traceable, allowing checks and comparisons to be made effortlessly. In Revit, you can annotate individual rebar sets, or you can use the multi-rebar annotation feature. Thanks to this option, you can annotate multiple rebar and rebar sets with a single tag. You can use these annotations to tag each bar in rebar sets with detailed fabrication and construction information. These dimension lines and descriptions can easily be changed to any style to suit local design requirements. If rebar designs are changed, all tags are automatically updated as they use data stored in the model parameters. You can better document multiple rebars within a host showing only a representative subset, enabling the creation of legible reinforcement documentation. This gives you the ability to create better, correct, detailed shop drawings of reinforcements. The bar presentation in Revit allows the reinforcement of structural elements to be displayed in a simpler, more readable way. Defining different bar presentation for a rebar set in each separate view gives you more flexibility in creating shop drawings. Schedules are very powerful tools in Revit, not only for rebars, but you can use them for rebars as well. They are a useful way to display model information and are essential when documenting your project. Revit provides you with a lot of out-of-the-box parameters that you can use in your rebar bending schedules, but you can also add additional ones if needed. Examples of provided parameters that you can use and are available out of the box are bar diameter, bar length, total bar length, quantity, rebar numbering, shape code, different bar segment lengths, etc., etc. Once your parameters are in place, your rebar schedule will list all structural rebars in your project. And then you can easily group, filter, and sort all data in your rebar bending schedules. Schedules are fully customizable, so you can adjust them according to your local standards. In Revit, your schedules are always up to date. Moreover, you can modify your models throughout these schedules. You choose how to most effectively manage your model data. In the next section, I will be talking about design automation.